Hello everyone, this is the part 6 of chapter 1, Introduction to Electronic Communication. And in this video, we are going to learn about the serial communication. We know that in serial communication, the data bits, they are transmitted bit by bit serially on a single line. So here, serial communication uses single data line, making it much cheaper compared to the parallel communication, where the number of lines, they are equal to the number of bits to be transmitted. So it enables two computers to communicate over the single telephone line, and byte of data must be converted to serial bits using a parallel in serial out shift register, and it transmitted over a single data line. Receiving end, there must be a serial in parallel out shift register to convert this serial data into parallel for the processing in the computer. For a short distance, the signal can be transferred using wire. So here, the types of serial communication are asynchronous and synchronous. So in a synchronous method, transfers a block of data or a characters at a time. Asynchronous method transfers a single byte at a time. So let's see the asynchronous serial communication. So in asynchronous communication, data is transmitted in zeros and ones form. So to have a sense of synchronization between transmitter and receiver, and to make sense of the data, transmitter and receiver agree on a set of rules, that is protocol, which describes how the data is packed, how many bits can constitute a character, and when the data begins and ends. So here is the asynchronous data frame is there, where start and stop bits, they are included for the synchronization purpose. So in asynchronous transmission, each character is placed between this start and stop bits, and this is called framing. Start bit is always 1 bit, but the stop bit can be 1 or 2 bits. So when there is no transmission, the communication line is held high, and this is called as a mark. Start bit always a 0, or the start bit is always a low line, and stop bits, if it is a single bit or it may be a 2 bits, then they are high. So LSB is sent out first when we send this asynchronous data serially. So LSB bit must be sent out first. So here is the framing of ASCII character A is shown in figure. So here, this is the data from D0 to D7. This represents the ASCII character A. And this is framed between this one stop bit and one start bit. So this start bit is always a 0. And stop bit is always 1. So when there is no transmission, this line, this transmission line is always held high, and that is called as a mark. And this start bit must be 0, indicating the start of a frame. So the transmission begins with a start bit, followed by the LSB D0, then the rest of the bits until MSB, and finally the one stop bit indicating the end of the character. They are transmitted on the line. When there is no transfer, the signal is high, which is referred to as a mark. And the data communication has speed up to 1200 to 2400 baud with a asynchronous transmission method. Then asynchronous communication. So in the synchronous technique, start and stop bits are not transmitted, but the data is transmitted in a multi-word blocks with a synchronization bits along them. And a group of synchronization bits are placed at the beginning of the multi-word block and at the end of the multi-word block. So this makes synchronization between the transmitter and receiver. To understand synchronous data transmission, consider the example here. So here are the blocks of a data. They are transmitted at a time in a synchronous communication. So here are these two blocks. They are nothing but the two 8-bit synchronization characters. They are used for the synchronization purpose. Then this is the first data byte. This is the second data byte, and this is the last data byte. So here the number of data bytes they are transmitted at a time. So at the end, here is the end of transmission character, and if there is error between the transmission, then the error check block is added with the frame. So as shown above, at the beginning of each block, unique series of bits identifying beginning of the block is added, whereas at the end of the block, another special code, that is ETX signaling end of transmission, is attached. The two 8-bit synchronization characters signal indicates start of a transmission, which is also indication for receiver to receive the continuous data after 8. As soon as this ETX code is received, receiver recognizes the end of transmission. In between this synchronization characters and ETX signal, some error detection and correction codes are also added. So as the extra 8-bit synchronization characters SYN and ETX are added to data signal, the speed of synchronous transmission is extremely high. So this is because the data is in the form of a multi-mode block, and also the SYS, that is the synchronization characters, and ETX signals used are much less than start and stop signal in case of synchronous data transmission. So thus, synchronous data transmission is much faster than the asynchronous data transmission. So here are the questions based on this topic. Synchronous data transmission is much faster than asynchronous data transmission. Comment. So that we have seen in the last slide. Then transmission type, which transmits data one character at a time with the sender and receiver not synchronized with each other, is called as find out the answer. Ethernet, internet, synchronous communication, or asynchronous communication. Thank you.